Holy crap, guys. Okay, this is Tacho, and out of nowhere, we just got this early drop trailer for Fire Emblem Heroes. It looks like it's going to be a Three Houses banner, and it's featuring a lot of most wanted characters from that game, so this is pretty awesome. We're just going to take a look at them one by one. We're going to talk about their skills, and then I'm just going to give my verdict on whether or not they're worth summoning for and whether or not you may want to summon on this banner. So we're going to start things off with President-elect Bernie Sanders over here. Vote for Bernie, guys. Bernie for president. So Bernie, she's got Persecution Bow as her weapon. Effective against flying foes, like all bows are. Grants attack +3. And at the start of combat, if there is a penalty active on unit, or if unit's HP is not full, grants attack and speed up 5 during combat. So that's going to be pretty easy to get to activate. Doesn't seem too hard. If unit initiates combat, unit can make a follow-up attack before foe can counterattack. Okay, so on top of that, it's also giving her desperation innately. So that's pretty rad. That's going to be a devastating bow. Not bad at all for a perf weapon. And then it just explains penalty. We all know what penalty is. Okay, her assist is Ardent Sacrifice. I don't know. That's kind of trying to combo with her weapon there to get her lower on HP so you can activate all the effects. But I don't know. I don't think you need Ardent Sacrifice. Especially not when we look at her A slot and find out that she has Attack and Speed Push 4. That's already going to lower her HP from full. So, I don't know why she has Ardent Sacrifice. Just go ahead and scrap that for something better. And then in the B slot, she's got Lull, Speed, and Defense 3. These Lull skills are really awesome. It's just crazy being able to negate stat bonuses from two different stats and then take away 3 points from them as well. Really good at hindering the foes and making it easier for your units to take them out. And then finally in the C slot, she's got Close Guard 3, so pretty good stuff. She does have some competition from other bow units, especially the one that came out on the Mirage banner. I forget the name of that one, but she looks pretty good regardless. Having innate desperation is, of course, very good. Her weapon doesn't seem too bad, and honestly, Bernie is a fan favorite character. If you've played Three Houses, you already know. So I would say if you like Bernie, then definitely go ahead and summon for her if you want. All right, next up, we've got Annette. She has Crusher as her weapon, which, I don't know, to me it kind of looks like she's holding a broom or something, but I don't know, Annette is kind of childish in Three Houses, so maybe she doesn't want to do chores and clean up. Okay, so Crusher, it's an axe weapon. She is an infantry axe unit. It grants attack +3, calculates damage using the lower of foe's defense or res. Okay, that's pretty cool, and it plays to the character. She is a magic-based character in Three Houses, so it's nice that they gave her a weapon to kind of show that off. If a rally assist skill is used by unit, target can move one extra space, that turn only, and does not stack. No effect on cavalry allies within range of 2. Okay, so this is actually pretty interesting. It's going to be able to allow your allies one extra movement, and we all know how crazy Legendary Azura is because of this. It doesn't work on cavalry allies, so you can't go nuts and have 4 range of movement. But still, I mean, being able to give infantry or flyers or armored units even an extra movement space per turn when she rallies is going to be amazing. So she's going to probably shake up the meta a little bit in Aether Raids. I'm going to be interested to see some team comps people have with her. Her assist is Rally Attack and Speed Plus. Very good. No need to talk about that. In the B slot, she has Defense and Res Ruse. I also like these skills as well, because you can just inflict guard on a foe. Really crazy good in a mode like Rooker Sieges, where being able to stop the foe from getting special attacks is very devastating to them. Also, it's going to cause Defense and Res -5 on them too. So, a pretty decent B skill. And finally, in the C slot, she's got Attack and Defense Gap 3. And at the start of the turn, grants Attack and Defense +5 to the ally with the highest Attack and Defense total for one turn. These are pretty cool because it doesn't really matter what range they are in. They could be all the way across the map, and as long as they have the stats, they're going to gain this bonus. So, really good skill. Overall, she doesn't look too shabby, and of course, her weapon granting extra movement space is going to be crazy. So definitely keep an eye out for Annette. She's going to be causing some trouble. Okay, next up we've got Ferdinand von Eyre. He is Ferdinand von Eyre. There is no other Ferdinand von Eyre. There is only one Ferdinand von Eyre. And if you played Three Houses, he would have told you that like 50 times. So, oh man, what did they do to this poor guy? Okay, we found the demote, guys. He's only got 4 skills, and they're kind of sucky. So, yeah, we found the demote. Poor Ferdinand von Eyre, man. He did not deserve this. But I digress. He's got Vanguard Plus. We've seen that before. Reposition. Oh, actually, that's not too bad. If he's going to be a demote with reposition, pretty good. Fortress Defense 3. So we've seen that already a very long time ago on Lucas. And in the C slot, he's got Rouse, Speed, and Defense 3. Oh, actually, wow, that's pretty good. If he's going to be a demote with that skill. Okay, all right. I see you, Ferdinand von Eyre. I see you. All right, the homie's putting it in, looking like a pretty good fodder summon, so that's always nice to see. And I didn't mention this, but he is a blue lance horse, so again, pretty cool stuff. Okay, and last but not least, we have Lysithia, who, I don't know, the artwork they went with for her here looks kind of like the Pokemon Slurpuff. I don't know, she's like all white and fluffy, so that's the first thing that popped into my mind. Let me know in the comments section down below if you agree with that. But her weapon is Hades Omega. I think that's what that Greek numeral is, or Greek alphabet. It's either Omega or Theta. I am not the best when it comes to the Greek alphabet, so let me know in the comments which Greek symbol that is. I believe it is Omega, though. Okay, but anyway, she is a Red Tome Infantry, and this weapon accelerates special trigger cooldown count, -1. And if unit initiates combat, attack and speed up 4 is granted to her. And if unit special is ready, grants an additional attack up 6 during combat. Alright, so she's kind of like a nuke unit, I guess. Her weapon overall is going to end up looking pretty similar to the refined Durandal that Elliewood eventually got, where he gets Deathblow 3 and then an additional Swift Sparrow. So, pretty cool stuff for a ranged weapon, of course. Gonna be nice, and she has special cooldown count -1. Looks like a pretty solid weapon. She has Moonbow as her special attack. Not too much to say about that, it is a good option. Deathblow 4 in the A slot, so she's definitely trying to nuke, and that's how she played in Fire Emblem Three Houses. She was primarily just a nuke unit with high attack and just destroying everything with dark magic. In the B slot, she's got Lull, Speed, and Res 3. This is a brand new Lull skill, and if she's not really going to have a lot of speed, I don't think this one is going to be exactly what you want. You probably want maybe Lull, Attack, and Res instead that Mirage Tharia had, or what was that lady's name? Curlia or Kyria? I don't know, man. Don't at me on that, but basically the Lull skill that character had is probably what you'd want on Lysithia. But of course, coming with a Lull skill right out the gates is going to be helpful, and you won't have to worry about inheriting something too crazy on her, since you'll be able to get by with that for sure. And finally, she's got Time Pulse 3. Again, we've seen this before on Sothis, but it is a really good skill, and combined with her weapon, that's actually going to be pretty nuts. I can already see it now. Just ditch Moonbow and give her Ruptured Sky or another crazy two-hit special, maybe even Glimmer, I'm not sure yet. But she's going to be outputting crazy high damage. And I know everybody loves Lysithia, so I can't sit here and tell you guys not to summon for her. She's going to be pretty rad, and definitely looks like she's worth going for. Okay, but at the end of the trailer, we also got a nice little extra reveal there. It looks like the Flame Emperor is going to be coming to the game as well, most likely as a Grand Hero Battle unit, or maybe a Tempest Trial unit, I'm not sure yet, but I'm thinking it's more likely he'll be a Grand Hero Battle unit instead. And what is there to really say about the Flame Emperor? I'm not going to spoil it for those who haven't completed Three Houses yet, but the Flame Emperor is definitely a character to keep an eye on, and pretty awesome that they're being added to the game. It's going to be real interesting to see how they work. And honestly, now that I think about it, the Flame Emperor kind of looks like Zack from Advance Wars, if you guys have played Advance Wars. Primarily Dual Strike and what was the second one? Chaos something, I don't remember. It's been, Black Hole Rising, my bad, guys. Yeah, so it has been a hot minute since I've played Advanced Wars, but yeah, if you guys know Zack, the Flame Emperor kind of looks a little bit like him. Or I don't know, maybe even Amon from, like, Legend of Korra. I don't know, I'm just making all these comparisons to the Flame Emperor, but that's pretty much who that character just reminds me of. It's just a red mask on, like, a mysterious character. So yeah, that's pretty cool that the Flame Emperor was revealed and we will be getting them in the game. So that's going to wrap up the breakdown for the units, guys. Hope you enjoyed this discussion, and whether or not you should summon for these units, I think they kind of speak for themselves. They're all pretty good, and they're all fan favorite characters, so of course, definitely summon if you're interested. As far as whether or not they're going to be meta, I think Annette may be the one to watch out for the most with her weapons effect. Granting one extra movement space is pretty insane, and I can already see some shenanigans with that for Aether Raid's defense setups. But she does not dance, so she's not going to be quite as insane as Legendary Azura, though. So there is that. But as far as the other units, they all look pretty solid. They've got great weapons, great skills. And even Ferdinand von Eyre, who is going to be the demote, it looks like, is going to be a pretty nice demote with reposition and arouse skill in his C slot. So very good stuff, very good banner, and I'm glad that they're finally giving some more Three Houses options. So that's going to wrap this one up, guys. Hope you enjoyed, and as always, this is your boy Tacho signing out. So I'll catch you guys again in the next one.